The Chinese public lashed out at Tesla founder Elon Musk after it complained that its space station had to take emergency evasive action to avoid collision with satellites launched by Musk's Starlink program. According to a document submitted by China earlier, Starlink Internet Services satellites had two close encounters with the Chinese space station on July 1st and October 21st. According to a document published on the website of the United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs, a preventive collision avoidance system has been implemented for safety reasons. There has been no independent verification of these complaints. SpaceX did not respond immediately to a request for comment. But let's take a moment before discussing it briefly. Hey guys, welcome to the Elon Musk Planet. Get the latest Elon Musk news by subscribing and turning on your notifications. Also, leave a thumbs up to show your love. Having said that, here we go. One user posted on China's Twitter-like Weibo microblogging platform on Monday that Starlink satellites were just a pile of space junk, while another described them as American space warfare weapons. The number of satellites and other debris orbiting the planet is estimated to be nearly 30,000, and scientists have urged governments to share data in order to reduce the possibility of catastrophic collisions. Currently, SpaceX has deployed nearly 1,900 satellites for its Starlink broadband network, and it is planning on deploying more. On Weibo, a user posting under the name of Chen Haiying said, "The risks of Starlink are gradually being exposed, and the entire human race will be forced to pay for their business activities." Despite the risks posed by space debris, NASA was forced to halt a spacewalk abruptly at the end of November. In response, Musk tweeted that some of the Starlink satellite orbits had been adjusted to reduce the possibility of collisions. In April, the country began constructing its first space station after launching Tianhe, the largest module of their three structures. After four crew missions, it is expected that the station will be ready to be occupied by the end of 2022. However, Musk, the CEO of Tesla Motors, has become a well-known figure in China. Though its electric vehicle business has come under greater scrutiny from regulators since a customer climbed on top of a Tesla at the Shanghai Auto Show last April to protest against poor customer service. At the same time, China has been improving its capabilities in the field of space as well. Officials from the Chinese government have reacted swiftly to SpaceX's Starlink constellation, which is expected to be deployed in 2020 as part of an aggressive deployment strategy. In response to this, various improvements have been made in the way of policy, financing, and technologies are implemented, including the creation of China Satnet, which is China's own constellation, and Guowang National Network, which is China's own transmission network. In spite of the fact that Satnet and Guowang are in their early stages of development, they are likely to compete with Starlink and others in some markets, while also serving similar strategic functions from a government perspective. Moreover, there is a good chance that we will witness the emergence of a red Starlink over China and the rest of the world in the coming years, supported by a wide range of stakeholders. In response to the coordination of key players in China's space industry, the country is preparing to launch the country's first national satellite internet mega-constellation in the near future. However, senior officials have recently stated that the state-owned enterprises in the space industry have been preparing amendments to the previous constellation plans and may be included in the Guowang or National Network Satellite Project for internet connectivity. Therefore, China submitted to the International Telecommunication Union, ITU, applications for spectrum allocation detailing plans to build two constellations of satellites in low Earth orbit, containing a total of 12,992 satellites in September of 2020. According to the filings, GW consists of a constellation of subconstellations whose altitudes will range between 500 to 1,145 kilometers and their inclinations will range between 30 to 85 degrees. Additionally, all satellites will operate in multiple frequency bands. Chinese space official Bao Weimin acknowledged the mega constellation plan publicly as a senior official at China Aerospace Science and Technology Corp, CASC, the country's main space contractor. As he explained, "We are planning and developing space-based internet satellites and have already launched test satellites." Bao added, "A national network, Guowang, company will also be established to be responsible for the overall planning and operation of the satellite internet construction." As well as Ge Yujin, president of China SpaceSat Co. Ltd., which is a part of CASC, said the Hongyan and Hongyun broadband constellations previously planned by CASC and sister company China Aerospace Science and Industry Corporation, CASIC, respectively would be altered by authorities. According to Ge, "Relevant national departments are doing overall planning for constellation construction, and Hongyan and Hongyun will undergo major changes." According to the recent figures from 2018, both constellations contain hundreds of low-Earth orbiting communication satellites. Since then, several technology verification satellites have also been launched. By the end of this year, CASC hopes to have 60 Hongyan satellites in orbit. The comments suggest the older constellations may be incorporated into the new, larger national network initiative. Although the progress of the project is unclear, the government has decided to make satellite internet a national priority. Chinese officials, however, added satellite internet to their list of new infrastructure in April 2020. Additionally, in the recently approved 14th five-year plan, as well as long-range objectives until 2035, a global network of communications satellites, Earth observation satellites, and navigation satellites is suggested. But that was for space constellation, China also bothering Musk's Tesla in China. Since Tesla attracted criticism from activists after opening a showroom in Urumqi, the capital of China's Xinjiang region, where authorities have cracked down on Uyghurs, the car manufacturer announced the opening of the new showroom on the Chinese social media platform Weibo, announcing, "Let's start Xinjiang's electric journey." The announcement was condemned by Muslim activist groups. Ibrahim Hooper, National Communications Director of the Council on American-Islamic Relations, said in a statement, "No American corporation should be doing business in a region that is the focal point of a campaign of genocide targeting a religious and ethnic minority. Elon Musk and Tesla must close this new showroom and cease what amounts to economic support for genocide." The news came at a time when President Joe Biden signed legislation preventing goods made by Uyghurs and other Muslim ethnic groups in the Xinjiang region from entering the US. Senator Marco Rubio, who was at the forefront of drafting this law, took to Twitter to slam Tesla's move. He tweeted, "Nationless corporations are helping the Chinese Communist Party cover up genocide and slave labor in the region." And as a result, the White House Press Secretary, Jen Psaki, also announced in early December that the United States would boycott the upcoming Beijing Olympics due to the ongoing genocide and crimes against humanity in Xinjiang. This results in several American companies coming under a lot of pressure both from Western organizations and consumers, and from Chinese government to take a position on issues, such as Taiwan, Hong Kong, and the persecution of Uyghur Muslims. And due to this, Walmart's removal of products made in Xinjiang from its Chinese stores and its Sam's Clubs, the retail giant, has come under fire by China's anti-corruption watchdog. The agency said in a statement that there were no justifiable reasons for the company to stop selling its products in an entire region, and that this decision showed stupidity and short-sightedness. They said, "China is Walmart's second largest overseas market. If they want to stand firmly in the Chinese market, they need to show enough sincerity and attitude. Respect the facts, distinguish right from wrong, respect China's principles and the feelings of Chinese citizens. If not, Chinese citizens and consumers will use their actions to respond resolutely." But it is important to note that Intel had apologized to the Chinese public before Walmart's run-in over its public letter to its suppliers, asking them to refrain from sourcing from Xinjiang. However, earlier in March 2021, H&M discovered its presence had been wiped off China's largest e-commerce, ride-hailing, daily deal, and map applications after the Swedish clothing brand decided to stop sourcing from China's Xinjiang region due to a dispute with the regional government. Not only Musk, but a lot of other companies are facing problems because of China, but hopefully everything will settle down and new relationships will form soon. But what do you guys think about this? Let us know in the comments. Lastly, if you're a science and Musk fan, then hit the like and subscribe buttons. Having said that, stay tuned for the next one. For now, peace.